Toastmaster od Evelyn, fellow Toastmaster, welcome guests. Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Today I'm going to talk about the basic technique for evaluation. When we are doing an evaluation here, it's a big responsibility. Why? Because we have to be honest. We have to deliver a fair critique. But under Toastmaster guideline, there are two techniques that there are together. One is the sandwich technique, and the other is the glove technique. They have to be at the same time, so when we are going to do an evaluation, we do it the right way and be fair, critique other person. It's a little hard, but if we use these two techniques together, and then we can be successful. The first one technique is the sandwich. You know, sandwiches, the good, bad, and then the good. When we start doing an evaluation, we start with the positive aspect. First, you did remarkable, your presentation was good, outstanding, appealing, everything positive. Then, in the middle, it should be, I said bad, because this is the expression that Toastmaster guideline suggests. But my opinion is we use areas that need improve, that the person can be better for the next presentation. Why I not agree with the bad? Because be here really is very hard. I remember when I did my first presentation, I was a little scared, but then now I'm relaxed. But it's hard. It's not easy. So when you are going to do the evaluation, the areas that they need improve, you have to be soft, because some speakers, they don't like to listen that, oh, you did something bad. Most speakers, they think, oh, I am perfect. But there are some mistakes that, and some correction that they have to be done for the next presentation. And why is the benefit? If somebody else tell you, is because it's for your own benefit, so you can become more effective in the next presentation. And then you are doing is again, back again with the good aspect of the presentation. But the critical feedback, normally when I do in a evaluation areas, I focus a little more in areas they need to improve. Why? Because the person need to know how I can do better on my next presentation. If I am focusing and I say, listen, you did everything fantastic. I listened many, many evaluations that everything is perfect. But when I compare what a Toastmaster guideline, I said, no. But the person say everything is perfect. And the evaluation start from the moment I shake my hand with the Toastmaster of the evening, when I share my hand, and when I finish the presentation here, I'm waiting for him, he's coming, and I don't move from here, I shake my hand. That moment is very important for any speaker. You never let alone the podium, always waiting for the Toastmaster of the evening. Now, let us back to the other technique, that is sandwich technique. The glove technique, excuse me. What they call glove? We were thinking, oh, glove, that is winter. No. Glove, G is a gesture. Facial expression. If I move around here with grace, if I look confident, if I don't show you any, like, that is the part, the gesture, that when I do an evaluation, I make sure if that aspect is perfect. Language, was the language clear, vivid, use beautiful word, eloquent, effective. The other is organization. You remember on my last presentation, I was talking, what is the organization of the structure of the speech? Body, language, the introduction, the body, and conclusion. I have to make sure if the person who did the presentation here follow that guideline, the speech. Because be here, talk. No, you need an introduction so we know what you're talking about. You develop an idea, sub idea, main idea at the beginning, then in the middle, and then the conclusion. Voice. Was your voice appealing? Can she hear me from here? Because there are more speakers talk so low, is my voice screaming? If I keep a tone, if I keep the rhythm. And the last one, if I show you enough energy, enthusiasm, if I'm happy to be here, you know how happy I am today to deliver this presentation. Over to you, Toastmaster David.